Good morning, good morning. It's me, Thais Love here. Just glad to be here with you once again with today's live. Today's live was supposed to happen yesterday for our Me Time Monday show, but I had to run out and get a new laptop because my laptop decided that it was going to retire and permanently, and so just before our show, so I was able to do that, and so I want to continue on with our Me Time Monday show, even though today's Tuesday. I wanted to make sure because Monday, this is the, well, yesterday was the last Monday of 2020, so I wanted to make sure that I finished our Me Time Monday for 2020. I wanted to make sure that I finished and finished on a positive note. I didn't want to leave anything undone. So thank you all for joining me and tuning in. Today, we're going to be talking about the seven areas, the seven life areas of wellness, okay? Last week, those of you who were with me, we talked about self-inventory. We are going through the different steps of self-care so that we can promote and increase our self-love. And so we've been going over the different steps. We went over the first step, which was self-awareness, and I went over it kind of quickly, but there's a lot much more to that, and we'll get more into that, and we'll go into the different steps in more depth as the weeks go by and things of that nature. But we talked about self-awareness, which was the first step, just becoming aware of who you are, as opposed to those that are around you, and what makes you different. Where do you stop and others begin in your life? Self-awareness. Then we went on to talk about doing self-assessments, the need to do a self-assessment. Self-assessment is simply, just checking you out, you checking you out, making sure that you're okay, just trying to see, what's going on within yourself. Self-assessment. We talked about the different self-assessment tools that are used to gather that information. And then we talked about ways where we can simply assess ourselves, a couple of questions that we can ask ourselves, just to, become aware of what's going on within us. Okay. Then we went on to step three, and that was last week, where we talked about self-inventory and taking stock of all those things that we need, that we desire, so that we can function more efficiently, function better, and so that we can be and feel better. Okay, so the week before, when we were talking about the self-assessment, that's when we asked ourselves, okay, what are the things that we need to function better, be better? You know, what are the things that we don't need, you know, so that we can function better, be better? Because we all have, you know, different things that we have collected and hold on to, and not everything that we've collected emotionally and mentally in life we need. Some things we just collected and, you know, it got good to us and we just carried around, you know, and then we become, you know, emotional and mental hoarders. So when you do the self-assessment, you can, you know, become aware of those things that you're holding on to that you no longer have need of or do not serve you well. Okay, so that's our self-assessment. And then we went on into self-inventory, where we have an idea of what it is that we need, what it is that we want, what we think we need and want so that we can feel better, do better. You know, but with self-inventory, we're looking at what it is that we have at this moment. What it is that we have. We literally take stock of the things that we have, you know, and that we want, we need more of, and those things that we, those things that we have that either we want to keep or get rid of, and then we also take stock of what we don't have that we either need to, we ran out, or we need to figure out a way to add that to our lives. So that was the inventory. And during that talk, I was encouraging everyone to take the time out to simply, you know, investigate what are those things that I have that I'm dealing with that I don't need, those things that I have that I'm dealing with that I do need, what do I need, where am I in a mental, emotional, and spiritual surplus of, and those things, and so I can decrease some of that, and what are those things that I'm in mental, emotional, spiritual sparsity of, those things that I've neglected that I need to pay more attention to, taking inventory that way and looking at those things. And so today we're going to be talking about the areas, the different areas in our lives that we need to actually look at and take stock of. We all have ideas about things that, you know, we think we need to help us function better or be better, it would increase our face value, stuff like that. We all have things that we think we need. Man, if I could just win the lotto, everything will be great. All my problems will be solved. If I just was able to, you know, get that house, that house, if I had that house, then, you know, I would have more space, and I wouldn't have to deal with, you know, all these people in my house right on top of me, you know, that kind of thing. You know, those are things that we think we need to help us be better. And we very well, you know, may be able to utilize those things and we'll feel better. And then again, maybe not. But today we're going to go over the 7 life areas that you need to pay attention to in order to maintain or increase your wellness. Okay? 7 life areas of wellness. Okay? And so I'm just going to go through the list of 7, you know, talk a little bit about it, and then that way you can take time out and take inventory, you know, real inventory. You can actually look at these 7 areas in your life and see, you know, which areas you've been neglecting, which areas you've been paying too much attention to, you know, and things of that nature. Okay? Now, the thing about these 7 areas, life areas, you need them in order to function, okay? And you function best when all 7 of these areas are in balance, are balanced, okay? Meaning that, you know, you are able to maintain, you know, and pay attention equally to all 7 of these areas. And so we're going to talk about the areas, then you can better look at, okay, I do realize I have some imbalances in my life, you know. Now you'll be able to pinpoint much better where those imbalances may be, okay? And then you'll be prepared for the next step after that, which would be the self-help step, okay? Which we'll talk about next week, all right? Okay, so the 7 areas of wellness, that's what we like to call it. Again, these areas, you experience life in all 7 of these areas on a daily basis, on a regular basis. So you need all 7, okay? Some you might prioritize as more important than others. Some you simply spend more time with and more attention to than others, okay? But understand that, you know, once you, you know, prioritized it like that, or you realize that I'm putting way too much energy into this area and no energy at all into this area, you know, once you realize that, then you can better gauge what you need to do to balance it. Okay? Okay. Area 1. Okay, I see that we have some people that are on and everything. Let me just quickly try to see if I can shout people out without bringing my phone all the way to my face. I have another device here, but I don't even see where I can look at it here. Okay. But perhaps, maybe, just maybe I can see it on the phone. But anyway, I'm just not going to keep on taking up too much time. And I do want to say good morning to all of you out there. So I'm just going to hold the phone to my face and, you know, on my laptop and all that kind of stuff. I'm going to work it out. Good morning, Sister Itaya. How are you? Thanks for watching. Okay. And then good morning again to Miss Sharon Kennedy. Hey, sis, how are you? How are you? Good to see you. Thanks for tuning in. All right. All right. So I want to go over these 7 areas of wellness with you all so that you can wrap up your 2020 in a strong way and be ready for 2021. Okay. All right. So the first area that we want to look at is your physical dimension, your physical life, your physical area. And what that area speaks to and refers to your physical body, you know, making sure that your physical body is intact and is doing well. The way to maintain or check that the physical body area of your life is to go for your regularly scheduled medical checkups, you know, and stay on top of those trouble spots within your health, your physical health. Okay, so if you know that you are scheduled for that mammogram or that you know, various tests like that, you know, go and take your test. Go and, you know, set up your appointment and go take your test, because you won't really find out what's going on within you and if everything is okay and working fine unless you go and you get examined. So do keep up with your checkups. Next month is right here, January. It's a really good time to start the year off understanding what you may or may not have to work on physically. So schedule your annual checkups, okay? Also, make sure that you are active. Your physical body, you know, signs of physical wellness is being active. Being physically fit. I mean, everybody's not totally physically fit. I mean, some people are more fit than others, but at least if you are able to get around and do all of the activities that you are accustomed to doing, you know, physical stamina, you know, making sure you get your rest and all of that so that you can move around and do all the things that you desire to do and that you have to do, okay? That's a sign of physical wellness, you know, being physically able, you know, checking out your energy levels, you know. Some days you might be more upbeat and, you know, animated than others. Looking at that and seeing, okay, what's going on, you know. I remember a good while ago, Mondays used to be my hardest day. I would, you know, do all the things that I like to do on the weekend, you know, I could catch up with, you know, my errands, and I could spend time with my family, and that always made me happy. You know, I would go to church, I would do all these things, you know, within that 48-hour period that we call the weekend. And so by the time Monday came and it was time to go back to work and, you know, get back into the week routine, it was, you know, Mondays were a time of adjustment, so I was tired, and Mondays, I used to dread Mondays, because it's like, oh my God, I gotta go back to work, oh my God, you know, and so I used to dread Mondays. So Mondays used to be really tough for me. And I found out they were tough for me because I was tired. And I was tired because I was trying to get the most out of my weekend. And I literally, instead of resting, some, I literally would wear myself out. So by the time Monday came, it's like, oh my God, what I gotta do? So I noticed my energy level was much, which was the lowest on Mondays. And so I started doing things to switch that up and, you know, correct that. And now Mondays are my favorite day of the week, because Mondays is, that's my day when I do my me day. That's my me day. Hence the show, Me Time Mondays. And so on Mondays, that's when I, you know, would do things to take care of me. I would not, either I would take Mondays off of my work schedule if, you know, I was able to. Now, you know, because I work for myself, Mondays are, you know, I do what I like to do on Mondays. So, but, you know, I had to shift some things around so that my energy level would be up on Mondays. You know, it wouldn't be the lowest energy day for me. And I wouldn't have to drag into work and, you know, be, you know, kind of sad. You know, I would be sad on Mondays because the Mondays meant that the weekend was over, you know. And so I changed all of that around so that, you know, I could, you know, Mondays is the day that I kind of, you know, set the tone for the week, you know, and Monday is my me day, so I like Mondays now. But I wouldn't have been able to do any of that and turn that around if I had not taken time out to check my physical areas of my life, okay? So, area one is your physical life area. Okay. Area two is your emotional life area. Now, your emotional life area, that's one of the areas that we live in all day, every day, 24/7. And when I say every day, I mean every day, you know, 24/7. We're always experiencing different emotions. And thinking about different emotions, you know, we emote, have our feeling. Emotion simply means to have your feeling. Emote. So, but we emote every day, all the time. And so it's important that we pay attention to our emotional life area. The way that you know that your emotional life area is healthy and well is when you are able to successfully express emotions as well as experience emotions. And you're able to talk about them. Talk about what you're feeling, and also you're able to feel for others. Okay? So when you're able to feel emotion, you know, you're experiencing emotion, you know what it is, you're able to express the emotion. You can articulate, you know what's going on, okay? I'm feeling not so happy right now, okay? This is what's going on with me. When you're fully aware and you're able to experience the emotion and express the emotion, as well as feel for others or empathize, that's when you know that your emotional life is healthy and well. The moment that you have trouble with any one of those areas emotionally, then that means that there's a problem and, you know, there's not all wellness. It might be, you know, you might, your emotional body might be, you know, trying to come down with something. Doesn't mean that you're, you know, totally sick. It might mean you're trying to come down with something in your emotional body. And so you want to get right on top of it and correct it. Okay? So emotional, your emotional body, your emotional life area. That's number two. Number three is your mental life area. Okay? Your mental, you experience things, you know, in a slightly different way from your emotional. Because in your mental life area, that's where your intellect is, your thoughts, your desire, your will to do things, your attitude. That's all part of your mental, intellectual life area. Okay? And so you want to make sure that that area is good. Okay? The way that you would know that your mental body, your mental life area, your intellectual life area, that mind thing, the way that you would know that that's well, okay, is if you are able to, your mind, certain things have to go on with your mind all the time, okay? Your mind, when it's well and it's happy, you're able to, your mind is active. So you're thinking, you know, you're planning, you're using your mind, and it moves. And it moves rather quickly. Okay, that's an active mind. Okay, you're learning, you're reading, you're researching. You know, those are things that, you know, stimulate the mind. So an active mind is a mind that is well stimulated. Okay, a bored mind is not an active mind. Okay. So, active mind is one that is well stimulated. So, you would do things that would, you know, stimulate your mind, make you think, make you want to learn, and learn stuff. So, you would know someone has, someone is, their intellectual life area is intact and well when you see them, you know, actively thinking, learning, exchanging. The mind needs to be inspired constantly, because when the mind is not inspired, you know, it gets bored, it starts slowing down, and then it just, you know, doesn't do anything, you know. So, an active mind, a healthy mind, is one that is also inspired, as well as active and doing things. It moves quickly. You know, you hear of that saying, people are able to think on their feet. You know, that's an active mind, meaning that they can think really, really quickly. You know, that's an active, healthy mind. So inspiration is key. Also creativity. An active mind, a healthy mind, an inspired mind will produce. and it will create. Okay, so the way that you can check and see if you know your mental intellectual life is well is if you know your mind is doing all these things. If your mind is active and moving and stimulated, if your mind is inspired and creating and learning and exchanging, you know, taking in information and processing it and, you know, exchanging those that same information with others. That is a mind that is healthy and well and active, okay? So if your mind is not doing some of those things, you might want to investigate why and see if you can correct it or get some help. Okay, and then the next, fourth life area is your social life. Your social life area. Yes, that is one of the areas that you need in your life so that you can function as a whole, well human being. So, yes, your social life area is very important. And so you want to make sure that you have a healthy social life area. And the way that you know that is one that has a healthy social life area is one that has the ability to interact with people across the board. Interact with people, all kinds of people, globally, you know, just, you know, any kind of person, you know, from all walks of life. You're able to successfully interact with them and, you know, exchange information with them while still being able to maintain your personal goals or objectives or the goals and objective that you hope to achieve when you showed up at that particular social situation. Okay, so your social life area, it has to be balanced. You have to be able to interact with others and have others interact with you, and while you still keep in mind what your purpose was for interacting with others, okay, and achieving that goal at the same time, okay? So, for example, social networking. Now, you know, you go to the business networking event, you go to it online, it's global, okay? And so you have to be able to exchange and interact with people from all over the world and do that successfully. Get your messages across, communicate, they communicate back with you, and you're doing this with all of these different people. And while you're doing that and they're doing that with you, you are still able to maintain who you are as a person and who you represent, as well as achieve your goal for entering in the social interactive situation in the first place. Okay? So that's signs of a your healthy social life area. Okay. Now, if you're in a social situation where you're interacting with people and you don't feel good about it, or they may not feel good about you being there, then there's a problem. And then you have to look at that. But I'm not talking about, you know, isolated situations. What I'm talking about is the ability to enter into social situations and interact with people comfortably, successfully, on the regular, or whatever is regular for you. Being able to do that and still maintain who you are and who you represent while you're exchanging and interacting with all these other people, that is at the same time, and achieve whatever goals it was that you had planned on achieving through the social interaction, that is you having a healthy social life area. Okay. Now, the fifth area is your spiritual life area. Yes, your spiritual life area, that is important. That is a part of you being a whole, healthy person. Your spiritual life area. Okay. Now, your spiritual life area is that area where you consider your values, your principles, your morals, even your beliefs. Okay. For some, that might be religiously impacted. For others, it may not be. But your set of beliefs, values, morals, those things guide and frame your life in such a way that it directs your life towards meaning. Everyone searches for meaning of their lives, and the spiritual life area, that's where you find it, and that's where we kind of store it. Okay, so you want to make sure that your spiritual body, your spiritual life area, is intact and well. And the way you would know that is if you are able to examine your beliefs, your value system, your morals, and see how, you know, those beliefs and morals and values and principles, how you allow those things, your beliefs, you know, and everything, how you allow that to frame your life and direct your actions so that you would find meaning for your life. Okay? So that's the spiritual life area. Okay? Now, if you're not sure, okay, why am I doing this? Or, you know, you find that some of your beliefs, some of your values, some of your principles that you held near and close to your heart, if they suddenly are not working for you, or if they are not helping you find meaning for your life, then that means that some of those values, principles, beliefs have to be swapped out, gotten rid of. They're those values, beliefs, those principles are no longer serving you in a positive way. So, you know, the good thing is you can always change it. Okay? So that's spiritual life area. All right? And then we're coming on down to the next one, number six, which is your environmental life area. Yes, you actually have an environmental life. Okay, maybe some of you knew it, maybe some of you didn't, but you know, I'm here to tell you, you actually have an environmental life. What is your environmental life? It is the way your environment impacts on you and the way you impact your environment. So yes, your surroundings does, you know, influence you. Your surroundings, it plays a very intricate role in all of the other areas of your life, you know. So yeah, your surroundings impacts your intellectual life. Your surroundings impact your social life. Your surroundings, your environment impacts your emotional life. Looking at your environmental life area, you would look to see how your surroundings, your environment, affects you, and also look at how you affect your environment. So, like your work environment, for example, you go to work. You know, you interact with people. If the atmosphere at work is not pleasant or if it's hostile, that will impact on how you act. It will impact on your attitude. It will impact on your intellect and your mental state. It will impact on your spirit, okay? So it's important to be aware and mindful of your environment, your settings, your surroundings, because it does impact on you, and you do, whether you realize it or not, you impact the environment that you walk in. You know, so the moment you step into the room, you know, the room already had a certain atmosphere, you know, before you stepped into that room. But the moment you stepped into that room, you brought in all that comes with you. And you impacted the spirit, you impacted the room just from walking in. Okay, so being aware of how you impact the environment and how the environment impacts on you, you want to be aware of that. That is that whole exchange is your environmental body, literally. Okay, and so you want to make sure that that is healthy. Okay, and the way you would know that your environmental life area is healthy is if the way you impact your environment and the way your environment impacts on you agrees with each other. Okay? So if you impact your environment in a positive way and your environment impacts on you in a positive way, they're in agreement. So then that means your environmental life area is well, because you created harmony between your impact on your surroundings, and you've created harmony in allowing or setting up your environment so that it impacts on you positively. Okay, so that's the environmental life area. You want to make sure that that's well. Okay, if it's not well, you can change it, or you can look at what you need to correct that. For example, me personally, I like the room that I'm in, especially if I'm going to be in it for a very long period of time. I like the room well lit. I like the room well lit. When there's shadow areas in the room, or the room is not well lit, it makes it difficult for me to think. I don't know. I'm more energetic and more active when the room is well lit. I know that about myself. When the room is not well lit or dark, then I get sleepy. The lighting in the room, triggers my brain to think, oh, okay, it must be time to go to sleep. So if the room is not well lit, I tend to be not as animated, not as physically active in that room. I literally will prepare to go to sleep, that's me with my, examining my environment and understanding certain things that I need so that I can impact and do what I do in that room comfortably, as well as, allowing my settings to impact on me in a positive way to help me stay positive and do positive things in that room. So another thing that I noticed about myself, if the room is cold, if it's too cold for me, I don't move around a lot in a cold room. In the summertime, when the air conditioner is on a little too high for me, it makes me sleepy. So my mind and everything kind of shuts down and prepares to go to sleep just because of the cold air. So those are just examples of things that you can look at within yourself with regards to checking your environmental life area. So that was area number 6, and the last area, but not the least, is your occupational life area. Okay, your occupational life area, that's your work area. That's where you choose to utilize your skills, your talents, your gifts. Okay, what career you'd like to work in? What would you like to do for a living? That's your occupational life area, okay? And your occupational life area, sometimes it could be not feeling well. Other times it can be very, very well, okay? the way that you know that your occupational life area is well is that within your occupational life, again, like I said just a few minutes ago, that's where you you utilize your skills, your gifts, your talents. You coordinate all three of those things to impact the world, and impact the world hopefully in a positive way. In your occupational life area, you know, you might come to an understanding that you like music and you're a musician. You want to choose as a career maybe something that would entail your love for music, and you would do that, choose that career, and you are the most happiest at work, because it's something that you're working at, something that you enjoy, and it brings you great joy. It also strengthens your skills, and you're utilizing your gifts and your talents, you know, in that particular job, okay? And it's a wonderful thing to be able to work at something that you love, okay? It's a wonderful thing. Because then when you're doing something that you love, it doesn't feel like work. For example, I love what I'm doing. I love what I'm doing right now. Love it. It's been a life's dream to be able to do it full time. And I am living my dream. And so it doesn't feel like work. It I'm happy, you know. You don't have to tell me to go to work. You know, I no longer wake up on Mondays feeling like, oh my God, I have to go to work. You know, no, I don't feel like that. In fact, you know, I get up before my alarm clock. And I wake up excited because I know, oh, this is a new day, and I, you know, get to help some people. And so I enjoy it. And because I enjoy it so much, you know, I put in a lot of time because I enjoy it. It doesn't, you know, like the time just kind of flies past. It doesn't feel like, oh gosh, another half an hour, and it seems like it's taking forever. No, it did. The time just goes right on by, and next thing I know, it's the end of my work day, and you know, time to prepare for the next day. So that's your occupational life area. You want to make sure that you are successfully balancing, coordinating the use of your skills, your gifts, your talents, and your career. Because when you successfully coordinate the use of those things, it adds meaning and purpose to your life. Okay? We're all created with a purpose. We all have purpose. It's just a lot of times, many of us, we haven't discovered what our purpose is. We're searching for our purpose, and as you search for your purpose, understand that it is connected to your gifts, your skills, your talents, and the things that you like doing. So as you search for what your purpose is, as you search for purpose, check those areas. See where all of those areas have a common point. And, you know, that's, you'll arrive at your purpose, or at least very close to it. Okay? So, but yes, it's important that your occupational life area is healthy and well. So, you want to look at that and see if it's not healthy and well, where you can improve it. Okay, so that that all of those things, your skills, your gifts, your talents, all those things are balanced and, you know, in harmony with each other, the usage of those things. And because once the usage of all of those things are in balance and in harmony, it points you towards your life's meaning. Okay? So, those are the 7 life areas of wellness that you need to have balanced and intact in order for you to function fully as a whole, healthy human being. Okay? Now, no one's perfect, but the more of a balance that you have within all of these 7 areas, the healthier, the more whole of a person you are. Okay? And so, if you have any questions or comments, you know, feel free to put them in the chat and everything, and I will address them. But you want to look at these 7 areas. Take full stock and inventory of these 7 areas so that you can be a better you. Now, I'm available. You know, you can talk to me. You can reach out to me. You can call me at 718-576-8110. That is the telephone number to Dunamis Sound Mind Services, for which I am lead mental health and wellness coach practitioner for. Okay? And we do a lot of different things where we can help you, you know, achieve that balance in all 7 areas at the same time. Okay? We are doing, we're running a special for the end of this year into the beginning of next year, the new year, where we're doing the Worthy 30 sessions. Worthy 30 sessions are 30-minute sessions at $1 per minute. So it's a 30-minute session for $30. Okay? And you can book your session today where we can sit down, we can go over any one or two pressing issues that you want to work on. We can sit down and talk and devise a plan so that you can execute that plan and resolve whatever that issue is. And if you want to simply plan and set goals for the year ahead, We have goal setting sessions that, you know, I'm available to set up goal setting session for 2021 now for you. And so feel free to give me a call and book your goal setting 2021 session. You can call me or you can email me. You can email me at dunamissoundmind@gmail.com. Dunamis, DunamissSoundMind @gmail.com. DunamissSoundMind is one word, all lowercase, @gmail.com. And so you can email me, you can call me, and we can book a session. Again, we're running a year-end special. We're running it all the way into the new year as my way of saying thank you for all of your support and just tuning in and your questions and everything, because you guys, with the interaction, you guys help me, you know, be better at what I do. You know, you guys let me know what it is that you really want to know about, and how you can better help yourself. You know, because at Dunamis Sound Mind Services, we help you be a better you. Yes. So, don't hesitate. Give me a call. Send me an email. We can do the Worthy 30 sessions, where you can use your Worthy 30 session for goal setting 2021. Or you can use your Worthy 30 sessions to take inventory of the 7 areas of wellness in your life. Or if you have something else, you want to work on, you've discovered, you've located, okay, this is a problem area, I want to work on it, okay, I just need help in figuring out what to do, call me and I can help you. You know, and the thing about me helping you is I'm not going to do all the work. You are going to help yourself be a better you. That's what I'm good at. I'm helping you so that you can discover how you can be a better you. Okay? So, let me see if there are any questions. There's some other announcements that I want to make as well, but I just want to say hello to those who are there. Hey, Terrell Young, thanks for watching. All right. And I shouted out Mr. William Williams, you know, thank you. Hey, Boo, my Boo is watching as well. Thank you. My husband, Kenneth Love, thank you. Thank you, Boo. Who else is here? Okay. Oh, hi, Shika. Hey, how are you? Sister Shashika Palmer, good morning. Thank you for tuning in. Risa Graves, hello. How are you? Thanks for signing on and let me know. Hey, Sharon. Sharon Kennedy. You like my color scheme? Mm-hmm. Yeah. I'm still doing it. Thank you for you being you, Sister Sharon. Okay. And all right. So I don't see any questions. Okay. You know, that's fine with me. Maybe after watching the video, you'll come up with some questions or some comments. If that what's happening, you know, feel free to still put your comments and your questions in the chat, because I do check the comments and questions with all of these live videos, you know, throughout the week. You know, if you don't want to put it in the chat, you want to give me a call, we could talk about it privately if that's what you want to do. Or if you like, you can send me an email, you know, just send me an email, you know, and I'll email you back, you know. So, but thank you so much for taking time out of your wonderful Tuesday morning to join me as I do this Me Time Monday broadcast on a Tuesday. I'm just grateful for my new laptop and all of my equipment that we were able to replace because my laptop decided it wanted to retire permanently. Okay, so I'll be here again on Mondays. This is, I normally do this on Mondays during our Me Time Monday show. And for those of you who may not be familiar with the Me Time Monday show, this is a show where we talk about things that we can do for self-care. During the Me Time Mondays, that's time that we take out for ourselves. Very often we're, you know, running around doing everything for everyone else and we neglect ourselves. So at the Me Time Monday show, that runs on Mondays, 10 a.m. or around about there. Because, you know, I'm experiencing a whole lot of growth in a short period of time, and I'm grateful. Thank you all. Thank you all. I'm, you know, making the adjustments, and I'm trying to make them as fast as I can. You know, along with things that I'm doing throughout the week with other people and collaborations. Shout out to Aunt Cece's Kitchen and my Aunt Cece's Kitchen family on YouTube. You know, shout out to Minister Chang Ajita with her show. And her Zoom meetings on Saturdays, you know. And so I'm pretty busy and everything, it's mushrooming, and I'm so grateful. And I'm just trying to keep up with the speed of the growth. But some of you that know me know that this was a good while coming. And now that it's here, it's just like, you know. And so I'm enjoying the work. I know I have a whole lot of work to do, and I'm so, so excited and ready to work with each and every one of you all. So, you know, reach out and, you know, and reach out and contact me. You know, I'm here for you guys. Every last one of you. And being that today is the today is Kwanzaa Ujamaa Day. And Ujamaa means collective, cooperative economics. Okay? And so on this day, We usually have some activity around cooperative economics. And so, being that I am, as you can see, a business owner and a business owner of color, you know, you all can practice some cooperative economics along with me and book a session or two or three. And like I said earlier, I'm running the Worthy 30 session special. And the Worthy 30 session is a 30-minute session at $1 per minute. So it's a 30-minute session for $30. You can book your session or sessions with me. You can call me and set it up. You can email me. You can go right to my website. My website is dunamissoundmind.com. You can go right there and book your session. You can even pay for it right there. You know, no fuss and everything. And so I look forward to meeting with each and every one of you. And so I'll be here again next Monday, which will be, today is Tuesday actually, but because I usually do it on Monday, but I'll be here again next week Monday, which will be a Monday in a new year. Okay, so next week we'll be discussing self-help, talking about the different seven areas of life wellness. That was, you know, an extension of the step of self inventory, you know, where I simply was sharing with you what areas you need to inventory so that you can decide, okay, where I need more help in, where I need less help in, where I need no help in. So that you can next week find out things that you can do to go get the help that you need, or start the process of doing the work within you. Okay, so that's next week Monday, the first Monday of the year. I'll be here again. Those of you who follow me on the Aunt Cece's Kitchen channel on YouTube, this Friday, January 1st, we're having another giveaway show. That's the next giveaway show. So stay tuned and look for the flyers, giving you instructions on how you can win some of the giveaways. Okay, shout out to those to the winners of our last giveaway, which was I believe it was a week ago. A week ago on Sunday. Yes, not this Sunday that passed, but the Sunday before that. We had a giveaway show and it was so much fun. Congratulations to all of our winners. And you know, if you didn't win last time, you have your chance this time. So don't forget to like, share, and comment on the videos, even these videos, the Me Time Mondays, you know, and you too can be in the running for winning a prize. Okay, we are looking for those that liked, or those that shared shared the most videos. We're looking for those which videos are the top videos that you liked, because we wanted to do like a countdown of the top five videos for 2020. So we need to hear from you. So and the way we will know which videos were the top videos that were shared is if you share them, okay? So you got between now and I believe the midnight the 30th into midnight, yeah, I believe midnight the 30th, but Miss Griffith will let you know and she'll put out the flyer. But you only got a couple of days left. That's basically what I'm saying, to like, share and comment on the video. We're going to be looking for the one of the top videos that were shared, who commented the most on those videos. Okay, we're going to be looking for the top shared videos. We're also going to be looking for the one who shared the most videos. Okay, so those are the three areas that you can participate in, and you will win. You will have a chance to win a prize and receive one of the lovely giveaways. Two Sundays ago, Deacon Sheila McElroy won a Kindle Fire. Okay. Another person won a book by one of our authors. And then three people won a half an hour session with me, energy healing session with me, where they got some stress and some stress relief and some pain relief. So congratulations to all those winners. And so I'll be doing that along with Miss Griffith on January 1st, New Year's Day. Okay, so you'll see me then, and that's Friday. And then Saturday, I'm not sure if we're going to take a break and be off on Saturday, but I'm usually on Sissy's Kitchen and doing a Facebook Live simultaneously on Saturdays at 6 p.m. and then again on Sundays at 1 p.m. So, you know, catch me on any of those. Don't forget to, you know, tune in and like, share, and comment on the videos. You know, come with your questions. We love, love, love your interaction, because that's what makes each video what it is. Okay? Okay? So be sure to do all of that. And let me see. Did I cover everything? Okay. Yeah. Oh, don't forget, book your Worthy 30 session. Book it today. Because I'm, you know, planning out my calendar for the upcoming month, and I'd like you to be on my calendar. So, you know, take advantage of the Worthy 30 sessions, the Worthy $30 sessions now, while they last, okay? Well, thank you once again. Happy Tuesday. And I'll see you next time. Bye-bye now. Take care.